Hi there, it's Steve from the future here, or is the thing that you're about to see Steve from the past? I don't know. Anyway, you may have noticed that I'm kind of quite a long way behind in editing up these videos and putting them on YouTube. This one that you're about to see is from early September. And when I was going through it, I realized that I had accidentally deleted some of the video. So the start of it needs a bit of explanation, because what I do is go through the replacement of the prop shaft and connecting the motor through and getting all of that done. But what I don't do is tell you why I needed to replace the prop shaft. So I thought I'd better do that here. So when I took the engine off, what you've got is the thing that connects the engine to the prop shaft and then out to the outside of the boat and to the propeller is a flexible coupling. The flexible coupling consists of two flanges, or kind of plates that are stuck on the end of the shafts, one on the engine drive shaft and one on the prop shaft. And then there's a kind of rubbery thing in the middle. I'm sure you've seen it on previous videos. And when I looked at this flange that was on the end of the prop shaft and measured it, it appeared to be completely unique. So they make flexible couplings of all sorts of sizes, but not the one that I had on Allison. So I went through loads of thoughts and plans. Could I remove the flange and then put one on that was the right size? I've got a brother-in-law who is a mechanical engineer. He came down to look at it, and basically he said that the only way that you could get that flange off the prop shaft was to have it machined off. The next thing I thought about is, could I get a custom one made, a custom flange and custom flexible coupling made? It turns out that that could only be done if I sent the flange to the manufacturer and then they could make up one to fit. Well, seeing as I couldn't get the flange off the prop shaft, that was a non-starter. So then I had a flash of inspiration, which was, why don't I just replace the entire prop shaft? And when I looked it up, the prop shaft came in at like £210. And of course, it would have cost me much more than that to do anything else. So that is a long preamble to, that's why I needed to replace the prop shaft, and here is the rest of the video. Morning. After my long-awaited success in finally getting the prop off the prop shaft yesterday, I'm now going to pull the prop shaft out. But first, what I'm going to do is reconnect my 12-volt power supply into the 12-volt system. And that's partly so that I can charge my phone, but mainly so that the bilge pump will work if I have problems getting the prop shaft back in and I have to bung it and I get some water leakage. So I think I've got about 4 hours before the tide comes back in again. So hopefully that should give me enough time to get everything done. I think this is the box that I put the power supply in. Let's have a look. Oh yeah, there we go. You've got to have a system, haven't you? Place for everything and everything in its place. So before I wire this up, I just need to make sure that these wires are going to be the right way round. So that on one of them, you can see there's these big minus marks, so that might be the negative, but I'm not going to take that on the trust. So making sure that these two wires are not touching, just plug it in now and let's have a look. Put it onto DC, trying to do this with one hand. I'm going to have to do it, stop the thing. Sorry, I couldn't show you that. I needed three hands there, so couldn't film it at the same time as I was taking the measurement.
It was a good job that I checked, because in fact the one with the minuses all over is actually the positive. I'm gonna connect it in now and then I'll have some power. So negative connected into the negative bus bar, positive connected into the positive bus bar, and my gas detector is on, powering up, and you can see that I've got 12.3 volts, so everything seems to be in order. I can turn the bilge pump on as well now. Okay, on to the main event. So this is it, pulling the prop shaft out. You can see what I've done here is I've just put this piece of tape around the shaft so I can see how far it's moving, or if it's moving out, because it is very stiff, and also that tells me how far to put it back in again. Right, here we go. I've got that done. That was exhausting. I mean, luckily it's a cool day today, but I am absolutely soaked in sweat. Here it is. That's the prop shaft. Ludicrously long. Difficult. There's no way I'm going to get that right back in this today, so I'm going to get it measured, try and get it far enough in so that it doesn't cause too much problem. Right, measurements. So first, length of the shaft. This is 60 inches or 5 feet, because obviously this is all in imperial. Second is the diameter of the shaft. So I've measured that here, and that comes out to be 1 1/8 inch. Third is the length of the taper on the prop. So I've just measured this, and it is, there we go, that's 2 3/8 inch. Measuring the length of the taper on the shaft, to me that looks like 2 1/4. Next is the small end diameter on the prop, which is that. It's about 0.9 inches. Let's measure it again. So I've measured it again, it is coming out at 0.91, so it probably is 0.917, which is the standard reading. So the next measurement is the small end diameter on the shaft, so that's about there. About right. So what's that measuring? So that's 0.9 something. So according to this, standard imperial temp would be 0.927. That's looking about right. Let's have a look. 0.8, 0.9, 0.92, that's 0.925, it's definitely 0.925, yeah, I mean it's not 0.93, could be 0.927, no, it's about 0.925, so probably. Next measurement is this key size.
That should be fairly easy to do. So that key is 0.25, would you say? Yeah, 0.25 inches. Apparently the standard size would be key size 1/4 inch. Yeah.
And the last measurement is the diameter of the thread, which weirdly is specified in millimeters. That distance there. Right, let's have a look at what that is.
That is in millimeters 20. Yep, that's the same as the standard. No, that's 19 mil, isn't it? That's definitely 19 mil. Gonna remeasure that.
It's still saying 19 mil. However, I think that they provide the nut, so I don't think that that one's critical, so they probably can make it standard. And the length of the screw is
31 mil.
So I got the prop shaft back in. In the end, I kind of got it a certain amount in and I couldn't get it any further, so in desperation I took this end plate off the stuffing box, which is the thing that stops the water coming in around the prop shaft, and it slid in easily, which is a bit gutting, but tells me that this stuffing box isn't mounted true. So I think that I'm going to look at replacing this with a modern dripless box, which will mean that I can get rid of this grease gun here. So it'll make the whole lot a lot neater. So when I've been looking at buying a new prop shaft, I was also looking at whether I needed to buy a new prop, because if you look at this here, which I think this length here, which I think is called the boss, is a slightly non-standard size. So anyway, I was reading the website and it said that the way you check whether the prop is still okay is if you hold it by the center and then tap the blades, then you can hear whether it's okay. So apparently it makes a kind of ringing sound if you tap it and they're still good, and it's a dull thud if it's beyond repair and needs replacing. So just tapping it now. So that sounds okay, you know, there is a definite ringing sound there. So maybe I don't need a new prop just yet. It's very exciting. Here's the new prop shaft. And here, I'm hoping, is the prop and the new flexible coupling. So I'm going to do the classic unboxing now. Here we go. What have we got here? So, that looks like the new prop. Lovely and shiny. Fantastic. Hopefully we'll find the nut for it somewhere. This is the half coupling which goes onto the motor output shaft. And then this must be the Sigma drive. Let's have a look at that. Instruction manual. Looks like some grease.
bits. Big bit of metal. And a whole load of nuts and various pieces. Super. So this is the thing, you can see that this is the thing that does the flexible bit. Cool. It's supposed to have 3 degrees of movement, which is quite a lot really.
Right, so the first thing to do is attach this coupling, this split coupling, to the drive shaft of the motor. See if it fits on. It does, that's good. So I'll line it up. That seems correct to me. Mm bolts. Probably some sort of torque setting that I should be using. I'm just going to get it up so it tightens for now. I do have a torque wrench somewhere. That's tightened. It's not quite in the right place. It's a bit tight. I'll have to undo it. Obviously, it's a bit tight for this ring spanner, so use the open end. Same on this side. Okay, there we go. Right, what I will do is I'll check the torque settings for this. Now I think I've got a torque wrench at home, so I need to go and get that and just make sure that these are done up right. But that bit works.
Harbour. Morning from a very drizzly and almost autumnal Scarborough Harbour. Although it's still very warm, so still summer really. So tide's out, as you can see. So today I am going to replace the prop shaft.
These nuts are 1/4 inch Whitworth. It's coming out. So this was the last thing that I was worried about. Is the new prop shaft the same length as the old one? And it looks like it's certainly close enough, so that's a big relief. Right, let's get it put in.
Well, that was a success.
The old Operation Swaparoo has been completed successfully, and I've even achieved my stretch goal, which was mounting the propeller. All I need to do now is wait for the tide to come in, and then I can tighten up the stuffing box so that the water doesn't come in. The one thing I didn't manage was to keep my feet dry while I was doing it. So I've got nice white wet socks and wet wellies.
We are so close now. So that's the half coupling. This is the Sigma drive. And right now I will be working on connecting the Sigma drive and getting the motor in the right position, except for the guys who sold me this, together with the prop shaft, all the bits. Unfortunately, they put the wrong size collar in. So this has got like a tapered collar, and obviously the inside is sized to fit the prop shaft, and then the outside is a standard size. And they sent me a 1 1/4 instead of a 1 1/8. Now, they were very apologetic and they said they'd get one out straight away, so maybe it'll even arrive today. But what it means is I can't quite finish this, but it looks so good. So excited about this now.
Good afternoon. So, some great news. The new collar for the Sigma drive arrived this morning. So I'm going to have a go at fitting it and then see if I can get the kind of temporary motor mount in position. So let's see how far we get this afternoon.
So the first step is to put these studs into these holes so that they match the holes on this half here. And at first it's not that obvious which you should use, but if you look at these, they're actually very slightly further out from the centre. And for this particular coupling, this particular half coupling here, it appears that the outer ones are the ones that we use. So what I'm supposed to do is put some Loctite on these threads, which they do supply, and then screw those in. So I'm going to do that now. Here we go. So let's see whether I've got that right and it all fits. That looks great. Okay, next part. So the next task was to slide this collar onto the prop shaft. It was a little bit tight, so I had to just use a screwdriver just to open this slot a bit to get it on. But it's on now. So unfortunately that means I don't quite know where the prop shaft should be. But I can sort that out, because it can slide forwards and backwards. And I want the prop obviously to be, I don't know, I suppose I want it to be, that's as far forward as it can go, maybe just a little bit further back than the front. So something like that probably would do. That gives me enough room to push the shaft back as far as possible. Okay, so the next thing is, apparently it's good practice to put some WD-40 on the outside of this, so I'll just find my WD-40 and put it on. Okay, so next is putting the actual flexible coupling bit on itself, and then threading these bolts in. These are all Allen bolts. And the instructions here give us a specific order for tightening them up. So I have made sure that I've left the slot at the top so that I can do that. But I suppose I can see the slot. Yes, I can still see the slot. So if I accidentally move it, then I can still recenter it. That's that done. So the next thing is, we've got these little blocks which you're supposed to insert to, and that holds the flexible bit, the movable bit, steady. parallel so that we can align it. So that's what I'm going to do now. Right, I've had to take it apart because I couldn't get those little plastic wedges in. What I'm going to do is just going to fit it up and then see if I can just put the wedges in before screwing hex bolts in. Let's see what happens this time. So I've got that done now. That was actually quite awkward to do. The best thing to do is just to put them really, really loose and then working in opposite pairs, just tighten them enough so that you can so that they don't fall out. So I did that, and then so got one pair in and then got the other pair in, and then I've just tightened it all up so that it's not moving. So there we go. Right, this is where we've got to. So I've got the motor to just about the right height. I cut a piece of plywood here and for here, and then use shims to lift it up so that it slides onto the coupling there. The back needs to be very slightly higher than the front, but a few washers kind of lifts that up. I think I've got enough information here now to measure up for the actual motor mount that I'm going to get fabricated, but I'd still like to get this one to the stage where I can actually turn the prop. So that's going to be something for another day, I'm afraid. But you can see how it's all going to look now. Right, I've got the actual motor connected up now. So everything is in place. I know it's not all aligned properly, so I can't put any significant amount of power through it, but I can actually show the motor turning round. So first thing is, turn on the controller. There we go. And then out here, we've got the throttle. Just a little amount. And there we go. It's turning. And it's turning the prop. Fantastic. There we go.
I've got the motor connected to the new prop shaft, new prop in place, and we've got a temporary motor mount in place as well, so I can see where everything is going to go. So next thing I need to do is measure up and design the actual final motor mount, which is going to take a while. And I'm going to make that the subject of my next video, but at the moment I'm going to leave us on a high with the motor actually turning the prop.